I call Stuart Nash.
Thank you very much, Mr. Chair. I'd like to talk about, to start with, Section 217. This is about a funding levy. And the thing that concerns me slightly, Mr. Chair, is what 217 basically does is it sets out the terms and conditions under which the Crown can actually charge an employer for WorkSafe undertaking its duties. So it's a form of user pays, I suppose. And at the moment, as we all know, employers do pay an ACC levy, and that's fair enough. But what we're finding, and a tax, it is a form of tax, there's no doubt about that. But what we're finding at the moment is, as the Minister of ACC, who's actually in the chair, not in the chair, in the House at the moment, has said, the ACC pot is incredibly full at the moment, so she has proudly made the announcement that she's dropping a whole lot of ACC levies for a number, far too late, for a number of employers. But what we have here, Mr. Chair, under Section 217, is the opportunity for the Minister actually to raise those levies once again. So what we end up here, but the thing is this is going to be collected by ACC. And there are a number of terms and conditions under which this can be brought in. And let me talk about 217, Part 7, A. Now, so what this is about is certain Crown costs. So what can happen is the Minister can determine that a levy is charged, and it says here, for certain Crown costs, and they determine WorkSafe carrying out its functions under any enactment. And what I would like to know, Mr. Chair, is if in fact this is going to be mandatory, if this is going to be put in place, because the way that it is worded in this legislation, Mr. Chair, is it is, because what it says is WorkSafe carrying out its functions under any enactment. And the way I read that is, you know, we all want a great WorkSafe, we all want an engaged WorkSafe, and we absolutely require a number of inspectors out there making sure that businesses and companies and employers are meeting their statutory obligations. That's a given. But the way this reads, Mr. Chair, is that the employers are going to be charged for this. And it also says the Crown administering, this is another condition under which the levy can be imposed, we're talking about C here, the Crown administering the relative health and safety legislation, and also for the collecting of the funding levy. So you can charge people a funding levy for collecting of the funding levy. And in fact, what can happen is ACC can then charge WorkSafe for the fact that they've collected the levy themselves. So what I see here, Mr. Chair, under Section 217, is a much greater level of compliance cost that is going to be loaded onto the employer. And what I would really like to know from the Minister and the Chair is if this is something that would be nice to have, let's see what happens with the costs, and let's see if they blow out, or let's see if the legislation is actually meeting its statutory requirement, and if it is, that's fine, away we go. Or if there's going to be any more money in an appropriations to actually bolster the number of WorkSafe staff to allow them to carry out their statutory obligations, or if in fact this is actually going to be implemented the day after or the month after this bill is enacted into legislation. And I would also like to know, because I can't see it here, that doesn't mean that it's not here, maybe I'm missing something, but I can't see the level of the levy that is proposed to be charged. Now, is it going to be a similar sort of levy as the WorkSafe levy? So for high-risk industries, for example, are we going to see employers actually paying double what they pay at the moment? Because I would suggest that for some employers, if you go and double the WorkSafe levy that they pay as part of the ACC requirements at the moment, that could actually be quite onerous. I mean, we all understand the health and safety, the reasons for health and safety in the workplace, and that's a given. We don't want to see men and women injured. However, if you're going to increase it by a significant amount, then I think that the people of New Zealand, the employers and the employees, probably need to know the level at which this is going to be increased, if in fact it is going to be increased. So there are a whole lot of unknowns around this that would require a level of clarification. Another clause I would like to talk about, Mr. Chair, is clause 211. And this is a health and safety work strategy. And what 211 part 1 says is that the Minister must publish a strategy called the Health and Safety at Work strategy that sets out the government's overall direction in improving health and safety of workers. But the thing that surprises me a little bit here, Mr. Chair, and I'm not too sure why the change was made, in 211 part 3, it did say that the Minister must make reasonable efforts to publish the first strategy within 12 months. But that was amended to 24 months. And Mr. Speaker, what we are, sorry, Mr. Chair, what we are talking about here is obviously a very important, Mr. Chair. Thank you much, Mr. Chair. Is a very important piece of legislation, but I'm wondering why the Select Committee saw fit, or someone saw fit, to double it from 12 to 24. Because even though it does state in the legislation here that it must be that the strategy must be undertaken with consultation with WorkSafe, and actually it says with regulatory agencies and with, and I quote here, I'm quoting 2116B, with other persons who have an interest in WorkSafe work health and safety in New Zealand. So it's obviously going to be a highly consultative process, which it should be. But I would have thought, Mr. Chair, that this process would probably be underway at the moment. You'd hope it would be, because you would hope that a government would have an overarching strategy for this to start with. But I'm not too sure why it's going to take 24 months. And I wonder, Mr. Chair, if that is the case, that if this legislation sort of operates in a little bit of a vacuum, not too much, because it is quite a prescriptive piece of legislation, but I'm not too sure why it was moved from 12 to 24 months. But the other thing also is, you know, when I see words 2113 here, the Minister must make, and then I quote, reasonable efforts to publish the first strategy. Again, when I see the words or the terms reasonable efforts, I wonder if that's just a little bit of an out to mean the Minister doesn't actually have to do it within 24 months. He or she can push it out to 30 or 36 or whatever they want. What I would have really have liked to have seen there, Mr. Chair, is the Minister must publish the first strategy within 24 months, not the little bit of wiggle room that exists, because I would have thought that 24 months is enough time to consult with those who have a really important part to say in this, get around the country and develop a strategy. Most important. The other thing also is, it says here, and again, I'm dealing with semantics, but you know, this is what the committee stage is about. It says that the Minister must present the strategy to the House as soon as is practical, and those are the terms in the Act, after the strategy or amendment or replacement, because the Minister can amend and replace at any time, has been published or made under the section. Again, as soon as is practical, gives a little bit of wiggle room for the Minister to decide whether it's going to be a week, a month or 2 months. Again, what I would have liked to have seen, because it is quite a prescriptive piece of legislation, something that said within 5 working days or within 5 sitting days or within a month after receiving it, just so there is a level of certainty there, Mr. Chair, that we know that when the Minister has completed the strategy, when he's done all his he or she has done all the consultation, that there is a definite time frame within which this strategy is then presented to Parliament for us to look at, for us to go to the workers and the employers and let them know what the government is actually talking about. Those are the only two clause at this stage, Mr. Chair, that I have questions about. But I just think that, especially around the funding levy, especially around clause 217, there just are a number of unknowns there that I think if we had a couple of answers, it might just clarify the position for employers and for employees. Thank you very much.
I call Denise Roach.
Thank you, Mr.